Hello all, it's Dr. Alsop here, and in this dissection supplementary video, we will be discussing structures associated with the temporomandibular joint, or as we like to refer to it, the TMJ. The majority of our focus will be on the associated ligaments as well as cartilaginous elements of the TMJ, and less on the osteology, as this will be covered in another video. And we're going to start with the articular capsule, and I'm going to outline it first, and you can kind of see that it's difficult to do so. It's basically this region here that looks like connective tissue. So this will be the articular capsule with a little bit of ligament there, and we'll talk about that ligament in a moment. But the articular capsule is going to be found in every single synovial joint, and the TMJ is a synovial joint. So you'll have an articular capsule which serves to attach the bones that form the articulation. The capsule will encapsulate the articular or joint cavity, and in the case of the TMJ, it also will encapsulate the articular disc. So while the capsule is still present or not dissected away like we have in this particular image, you will not be able to see the articular disc, and you will also not be able to see the articulating bones, which in the case of TMJ are the mandibular condyle and the fossa. Now, it is very difficult to distinguish the articular capsule from the lateral ligament, and sometimes the lateral ligament is referred to as the TMJ ligament. So, the articular capsule and the lateral ligament are very closely related. It's going to be right around this region here, is going to be considered part of the lateral ligament, as well as portions of the capsule. And as its name would suggest, it will be closely related to the lateral side of the articular capsule attaching the articular tubercle, which is going to be over here in this region, to the neck of the condylar process of the mandible. This ligament, based on its placement, is really important in terms of restricting posterior as well as lateral movement of the condylar process, so making sure that you don't have unwanted movements in this region. Because the articular capsule and lateral ligament are so hard to differentiate, sometimes darn near impossible, we would not ask you to distinguish between these two structures. Now let's locate an easier to identify ligament, which is the stylomandibular ligament. I'm going to outline it real quickly before we talk. So this is going to be the stylomandibular ligament. This is often considered a reinforcing ligament of the TMJ, so not playing much of a role in terms of mechanical restraints of the joint. This ligament is perfectly named as it extends from the styloid process, which would be up in this region, to the ramus and the angle of the mandible. And I don't know what happened here with this box. I apologize, it shouldn't be there. But it doesn't matter because that's what we're focusing on this region anyway. So it's extending to the ramus and the angle of the mandible. Now the mandible in this particular dissection has been cut in order to see portions of V3 and some of the maxillary artery, but you can really see it extending to that angle of the mandible here. Okay, once you remove the lateral ligament and articular capsule, as has been done in this particular dissection, you can see into the actual joint cavity, and the TMJ. And so the joint cavity, you can see some of the black right here indicating space. The TMJ is going to have what's referred to as an articular disc. And I'm going to draw an arrow to the articular disc right there, which is made of fibrocartilage and serves to separate this region into two separate joint regions. You're going to have the upper, or sometimes referred to as the superior synovial cavity, which is going to be important in protrusion and retrusion. So protrusion, think jutting out the mandible, kind of making it go anteriorly, and retrusion is bringing it back. And then the lower or inferior synovial cavity is going to be underneath the articular disc, or inferior to the articular disc, and is important in elevation and depression of the mandible. Lastly, let's discuss the retroarticular tissue, sometimes referred to as the retrodiscal pad or zone, and I'm going to kind of circle around it. What I always try to do is find the articular disc, which you can see really beautifully here, and then go posterior to it. And you see this area of kind of loose tissue, which contains neurovasculature, and it's going to be posterior to the articular disc, which has been, which you can clearly see right in that region. This area is important because it's often a site of edema in temporomandibular joint disorder. So that's why there's a, that's why we need to know this particular structure. All right, so this wraps up our discussion of structures associated with the temporomandibular joint, which is obviously a very important area when discussing mastication, which is the focus of this session. Please make sure to take your own time to review and let me know if you have any questions. Thank you for your time and attention.